it was a good year for the New Jersey Devils, who exceeded expectations, and obviously on a career year for one Mr. Taylor Hall. And joining us now, fresh off of signing a new three-year deal of his own, Blake Coleman. Blake, thanks for joining us. How excited are you to be a part of this team for another 3 years?
Yeah, I'm really excited. It was a lot of fun last year, kind of no expectations going into the year. So it was a fun season and looking forward to building on what we had from last season.
Blake, congratulations again. Well-deserved and well-earned three-year deal with the Devils. You had a terrific season. Moving forward, do you think you can even bring more offense? Because you brought quite a bit. You had a real good offensive year besides bringing that spark and penalty kill. But do you put expectations on yourself to do even better and improve?
Sure. Yeah, I think that there's certainly always room to grow as a player. And it's kind of been the path that I've had at every level of my career is maybe a little slower start offensively than I'd like. And then once I get a little more familiar with the league and the game, then usually kind of take off and get a little stronger each season.
Obviously, Blake, one of the big storylines this season for the Devils was the year that Taylor Hall had. Seeing him on the ice night in and night out, why do you think he was able to find so much success with the Devils? I mean, we all know he was a superstar player before, but he just took things to the next level this year. Why do you think that is as a teammate of his?
I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer when you're around him every day. He's such a good pro. He takes care of himself. He's a team-first guy. I know that when we clinched the playoffs, you know, he was kind of the guy that led us there, obviously, on the ice. But just emotionally, he was so invested. And watching a guy like that, it's so easy to rally around a guy like that. So I think that that's a big part of it. And another part of that, I think, is just his relationship with Coach Hines, the way they can kind of bounce ideas off each other and go back and forth. And they certainly push each other every day, and I think it makes, you know, him a better player, Coach Hines a better coach, and then you know, for us young guys, just to kind of feed off their lead.
Blake, Jackie mentioned the team exceeding expectations this year, and for all intents and purposes, we would all say that. You made the playoffs. I know you lost in the first round of the Tampa Bay Lightning, but what do you need to do as an organization, as a team, to even get better and make sure you make it again? We know every team continues to improve in the offseason, so there's still a lot of work ahead.
Sure. Yeah, I think that, you know, we're all pretty happy with how last year went down as far as making the playoffs. But like I said, last year there were no expectations, and this year I think we all have pretty high expectations for ourselves. So we're excited for the group we have coming back. And I know some people might think it's been maybe a little quiet offseason for us, but we have a lot of character guys in that locker room and a lot of good leadership. So I think that we're looking to build and come in strong, maybe start off the same way we did last year. And I think that having those expectations just kind of makes you hungry and you want to get back and you want to push yourself to be better every year. So I think with the group of guys we have, we'll be doing that.
Well, speaking of hunger, Blake, I can't have you on the show without bringing up the pickle juice incident from earlier this season. I'm sure you've been asked about it more times than you can count, but I'm going to ask you again. Did anyone reach out to you about this? Do you get free pickles now? I mean, what was the story behind the pickle juice? Everyone wants to know.
Yeah, it's probably the most bizarre thing that's happened to me in my entire life. Yeah, it was just kind of a freak thing that, you know, I ended up drinking out of the jar in the penalty box there. I think the first game of the year it was. And yeah, it's been left and right. I've gotten calls from, you know, probably 30 different pickle companies that nobody knows exists, and a lot of free samples and free pickle brine.
Living
and,
large, eh? Living large.
Living large. Yeah, I know. I should have gotten caught doing some of the Maserati or something, but pickles are a close second.
One thing at a time. One thing at a time, right?
Yeah, exactly. So, I think we're throw it out there. I guess while I'm on here, I think we're coming out with our own special line of pickle juice for next season. So I'll have my own.
Breaking news.
Blake, you're that's great stuff. I love that story, Blake. And you're gonna have a lot of pickles in the future. But quickly, your mate and from the same state, Stefan Nason, recently married, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
Sure is, yeah.
And just signed a new one-year deal as well. I mean, how special is it to have a Texas native on your team, a kid you played minor hockey with, grew up with, I mean, to see you two guys continue to improve and excel and be a big important part of the New Jersey Devils, does that add some a little bit to for you guys and certainly for the state of Texas coming from there, where not a lot of, let's face it, not a lot of National Hockey League players have come from the state?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm extremely excited for Steph. Obviously, he got a great deal there, and he got hooked for life on his woman. So things are looking up for him. But yeah, it's really cool to go home, especially in the summers, and just kind of share that bond. You know, all your buddies that you played with growing up, and everybody kind of reaching out, like, you know, just reaching out to me and Steph individually or together, and getting that, you know, congratulations and seeing how proud people are of what we've accomplished coming out of the state of Texas is a really cool feeling, and it's nice to have a buddy to share it with, for sure.
Well, Stefan Nason, from what I understand, not the only one to put a ring on it, so to speak. I understand you got engaged on July 1st. Congratulations, first off. And second, yep. How did you do it? How did you ask the question?
Yeah.
I'm putting you on the spot now. Blake, tell us everything.
Seriously, yeah, it's all over for both of us now. it was fun. We planned a little event out at the lake, a little lake house that her family has, and made sure I got all of her friends in from out of town. And I think she was on to me. I don't think it was too good of a – I'm not good at keeping secrets, but –
Or she's just she's a really smart woman. Good for her.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that's her side of the story. No, it was really cool. Yeah, we had a lot of the family out there from both sides, and all our good friends, and just a weekend of celebrating. And that was the start of a really fun summer and a really exciting summer for both of us. So it's been fun to share it with her.
Well, congratulations again. It's been a heck of a year for you, a great year with the Devils, a new deal, and an engagement. So congratulations again, and thanks for joining the show. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks a lot, guys. I appreciate you having me on.
Enjoy the rest of your summer.
Congratulations, yeah, Blake.
Oh, and the pickles, too. Congratulations on the pickle deal. That's awesome, too.
Yeah.
How can I forget?
Yeah, most important part.
See you later.